k-anonymity, a model for protecting privacy. Sharing and releasing data is necessary for research, scientists, data mining, cost analysis, fraud detection, transparency, and many other fields. It is an essential tool for our societies. As technology progresses, we are seeing an exponential growth in the data collections containing person-specific information. Data holders operating autonomously are left with the difficult task of choosing what data can be released and in what way. Releasing information without properly protecting the privacy of the people representing in it can be a serious threat. It can harm those peoples and others, in some cases even national security. Suppose some health organization has a database containing names, dates of birth, addresses, zip codes, penis sizes, and others. For research purposes, they want to release this information to the public. Of course, they remove the name and address data from the file, since the information released is quite delicate. At the same time, another database is released, containing name, address, date of birth, and voting data. According to a study in USA, 87% of all people can be uniquely be identified by their zip code, date of birth, and gender. So, let's match the data. Result: a database that links names and phone numbers to penis sizes. This is not just a theoretical possibility. In 2002, researchers were able to use so-called anonymous data to link the governor of Massachusetts to its medical registration. And now, we have a problem. How can we still improve the world by sharing data with researchers without leaking private information? The usual way in which privacy is handled is by suppression, which consists of removing only information that might help identify the person. This usually includes name, address, and phone number, but it can also include some less obvious piece of information, such as the zip code, gender, or race. However, this technique may render the information useless for many applications, up to a point that we may as well not release anything. Another common practice is introducing noise, altering the data to still keep the essence of it, but making it untraceable. However, this technique may corrupt the data to a point that wrong conclusions are extracted, or no conclusions at all. How about security? Why not just limit the access to the data to specific researchers? In some cases, this can be a solution. However, our objective is to release information without exposing individuals, not restricting access to the information. First method is so-called k-anonymity. Let us first present a common way to store data in tables. In such a table, each row corresponds to an individual, and each column corresponds to an attribute of that individual. There are some special kinds of attributes that will be relevant for this topic: identifiers, quasi-identifiers. Identifiers allow us to clearly identify a person, such as some BSN number or their name. Quasi-identifiers are a broader term, which includes identifiers and other attributes that may appear in other public databases and may allow identifying the person linked to the data. Example of this can be gender, zip code, or race. We'll assume that the data holder knows what attributes in its data are quasi-identifiers. This might not always be true, but legislation and policies can help them find out. If at least k people share the same quasi-identifiers in the same table, then no individual can be individually traced. This concept is known as k-anonymity. As an example, let us anonymize the data in this database using k is 2. We'll start by removing the identifiers in this case the name, and will apply k-anonymity to the other quasi-identifiers. We can see that there are at least two of each phrase, so we then not make modifications. Next, we look at the dates of birth. They are all different, therefore we will simplify it by leaving only the year. After this modification, there are at least k persons with the same birth date for each birth date. Now we will pay attention to the gender, which again is not problematic as each gender is repeated more than once. Finally, we look at the zip code and we can see that they are again singular. We'll modify them by removing the last digit, which reduces the precision of the location without crippling it completely. Let's now check all rows. We see that no person has a unique combination of quasi-identifiers and can therefore not be traced. We reduced precision of the data, but we did not cripple the data more than is really needed. We had to make compromises on the birth date and zip code. Perfect! We're done, right? Unfortunately, no. This method of anonymizing can still be vulnerable to certain attacks. We'll show three possible methods. Unsorted matching attacks refers to the information of two different releases on the assumption that the order of the list is the same. For example, the database on the left is released in two anonymized versions, but two databases on the right. If we know that the order of the entries of the two released databases is the same, we can reconstruct the original database. The solution for this problem is shuffling the entries before releasing a k-anonymized database. Another possible attack is called the complementary release attack. This refers to the usage of two different releases of the same database in which attributes that were not considered quasi-identifier are used by a hacker as a quasi-identifier. In this example, two k-anonymous databases are released. Both released databases contain only one person with a hypertension problem, so we can combine both data entries into the one original data entry. By taking into account the previous releases of database, we can prevent this attack from happening. Finally, the last type of attack is the temporal attack. Imagine we make a k-anonymous release of our data. After that, we add more entries to the database and make a new k-anonymous release. As we added new values, we might have a different way to reach k-anonymity, which combined with the previous release might reveal personal information. This is a concept very similar to the one described before, and the solution is basically the same. To summarize, we have seen the need to release data in a safe way. We have described three methods for protecting privacy when releasing a database, with our main focus on k-anonymity. We've explained three possible attacks on released k-anonymized databases, giving solutions for these attacks as well. Thank you for listening.